and gentlemen, to the 2012 Midland High homecoming game between the Midland High Chemics and the Bay City Central Wolves, a beautiful rendition of the national anthem by the Chemics student singers. Hi, this is Dave Marsh bringing you all the action along with the old ball coach Frank Aldemore. And coach, man, beautiful night for football here at Midland Community Stadium, huh?
It's going to be a good game, Dave. Great game tonight. Great homecoming game for Midland High.
A big home crowd is pouring into the stadium on this beautiful fall evening as Midland High looks to remain unbeaten on the season. Chemics coming in with a perfect 5-0 record, 3-0 in the Saginaw Valley League. Meanwhile, Bay City Central checks in at 2-3 overall, 1-3 in the league. And Midland, with that 5 wins already, has posted their 36th straight winning season. Very impressive.
I think it's a wonderful accomplishment. I just, as an old football coach, that's number one thing you work for. Let's have a winning season. Then let's get to the playoffs. Then let's win the Valley. Then let's win the city championship. Then let's win one game at a time in the playoffs.
And so Midland is Midland High is another old ball coach, Terry Wilczek, just popped in to say hello as he's ready to watch some football. And we watch the Midland High marching band play the fight song. But as we were saying, Midland now needs one more win to secure yet another playoff spot. And they will be taking on a long, long-time rival, Bay City Central. They've had many classic games over the years. And it seems recently, Coach, that sometimes even when the records are differential, Bay City Central plays Midland tough.
Bay City Central always plays you tough. What they've done is they put themselves against better teams in the hole. And they fumble, they get terrible field position. And those are the kind of things that destroy an opening play. So you need to be able to understand where you're at, make them make some, we're going to take a look at some of our keys to this game.
Okay.
And now I think maybe that'll,
yeah,
may explain that a little bit better along the way. And I just kind of, I look at tonight's game as an opportunity for Bay City Central to kind of break out of their shell a little bit. Last week they put up 30 points. And last week Midland put up 40 points.
Yeah.
So is this Bay City Central going to continue this, and is Midland going to have a letdown from last week's big win?
Well, you're a great predictor of what it takes to win and lose ball games, as you have been over the years. So let's take a look at those keys to the game here, Coach, before kickoff.
All right, here's Bay City Central. Their big problem is turning the ball over. And they run the option. I always felt if you're going to run the option, you have to say to yourself, all right, the fumble is a part of the offense. And you hope that you're not going to hurt yourself. They hurt themselves with their turnovers. They need to move the chains. They need to keep the ball out of the hands of Midland's runners and passers. And the third thing is, I think you need to stop Alec Johnson. He is the key, and you can talk about a lot of things, but this is a quad player. He catches punts. He plays defense. He's a good runner. He's an excellent spot passer, and he's a terrific receiver out of the backfield. You got to stop him. Somebody has to be on him and says, okay, where he is, I am. Now, when we take a look at Midland, you've got, again, this idea of being able to avoid a letdown as we go along. So Midland's keys to the game are, again, something that they really strive hard for, good field position. I put down that you have to score 30 or more points simply because you got to get into the rhythm of it, and then I think their special team needs to make a score.
And so we're underway. Ryan Singer with the kickoff booms it back into the end zone, unable to return it due to the fact that he caught it in the end zone. It was Andre Houston. Ryan Singer, A senior, he's having a tremendous year, both as a kicker and a receiver for the Chemics.
That's one of the things about Midland special teams. They've always had kickers. that are in position kickers. Sometimes they kick it in the end zone. Sometimes they have a pop-up. Sometimes they have a low-line drive. And they're good enough to handle that. But now we're going to take a look at the first series here. And Bay City Central has kind of changed from the beginning of the year into their set. And, of course, that's depth, that play right there. You're going to run the fullback against Midland's low-charging lineman. See, nobody in the league charges as low as Midland. You can practice your blocks against guys that stand up and play hit and read. But when you play Midland, nobody charges as low and as hard as Midland.
Colin Gagnon on the defensive line with a great stop there on first down. Will bring up a second and 11 from the 19. Another quick handoff and stuffed in the hole. Devon Jackson with the carry, but brought down after no gain. So Terrence Thomas and Tyler Sove on the top for the on the stop for the Chemics.
Two runs, no gain. Now that's a problem. Now you're inside your 25 yard line, inside your 20 yard line, and now you've got to get out of this hole because now you're going to punt.
Austin Jones, number five, the quarterback. Quick step back, overthrows the intended receiver, Robert Meath. And just like that, it's going to be a three and out for the Wolves. Tremendous defensive possession, and it's kind of what you talked about here, Coach, is the kickoff and a tough defensive stand in Midland, no matter what happens, really is going to have great field position.
Great field position. They're going to get the ball again inside the opponent's 50-yard line, which is exactly what they want.
Alec Johnson, number 17. He's also the quarterback. And number 18, Thomas Smith, back deep for the Chemics. Nice high spiral, beautiful punt. Smith will take it on the fair catch at the 44-yard line. And so really a nice punt there by
beautiful punt
by Bay City Central. And Midland will take over on their first possession. And as we mentioned, Alec Johnson, the leading quarterback, leading passer in the Saginaw Valley League. He's thrown for 518 yards, 8 touchdowns, only 1 interception. And Midland High will start with the lone setback is number 24, Travis Patton, who himself is having a tremendous year. 3 wideouts out to the left. And Johnson calls up the signals in the shotgun. He'll hand it off to Patton up the middle, big hole, and he bursts ahead. Brought down after about a 4-yard gain.
See, now that was a good play to run. You get a little look at, if you notice, Johnson stood up, waited to take a look at what they had out there. They're gonna run no huddle, so they have a pre-arranged script.
Same
again, Bay City's in man-to-man all the way.
Same formation, again, Patton with a carry. Tries this bounce around, but swarmed under by a host of Wolves. Colin Wilbur, number 24, and Stone Manzik in on the stop, and it'll bring up a third and long situation for the Chemics, 3rd and 8 to be exact. Ball on the 46-yard line. And just joining us, it is Midland High homecoming game, 2012. Chemics taking on Bay City Central here early in the first quarter. 3rd and long, Chemics. Smith out to the right.
Number 7.
Rolling left goes Johnson and finds, oh, a tremendous catch. And he found his Will Williams out of the backfield. A great one-handed grab, hauls it in, and he'll take it into Wolves territory for the first down.
Will Williams is an unsung star. Last week I watched him make a move that I thought that is a way above the normal high school player down for a touchdown. And the first game of the year, he made a tremendous catch down in the corner in between two defenders.
Great
He's
job.
An exceptional athlete.
It's his 14th reception on the year. Johnson fumbles a snap, and he'll just fall on it to maintain possession. But it's going to be a 4-yard loss for the Chemics. Williams comes into the game, 13 catches, 174 yards, 13.4 yards per carry. Ryan Singer, the leading receiver for the Chemics, 16 catches, 170 yards, And Singer has scored four touchdowns. Second 14, Johnson rolls to the right, surveys the field, fires, Cass Smith. Beautiful pass on the money. Smith hauls it in, and it's going to be close to the first down. I think a little bit short.
See, I really like this because in games that I've seen earlier this year, when Johnson was on a rollout, he only had eyes for Singer. Tonight he's thrown two balls to two other people, take the pressure, a little bit of pressure off of Singer.
Had some good zip on that ball, too.
Right on the money.
Third and one for the Chemics. Hand off to Patton. He's hit immediately. I don't know if he got it. Brady Draves on the stop. No, he is held short. He's going to bring up fourth and about a yard for the Chemics. And looks like they're going to go for it. Really, it's too deep in the 34-yard line. Too long for a field goal, too short for a punt. And so Midland will be going for it here on fourth down. Full house backfield for the Chemics. 26 Scott Naples and 44 Nathan Fisher.
Too much time.
Delay a game. Wow, that's a big penalty. Just they changed personnel and just took too much time to make the change. And now the Midland will punt it now. Big penalty. Ooh.
Those are the penalties you hate as a coach, right there. You're too much time, or you're wasting a timeout because of it.
And the punt by Naples. Nice high punt, and oh, excellent try. Goodwin, Alex Goodwin tried to save it right at the goal line, the ball did trickle beyond the goal line, and so Basic Central will take over first down from their own 20-yard line.
See, again, if we take that look back at our keys here, we're talking good field position. Midland is still in good field position. Basic Central is still in bad field position, and Basic Central just has not moved the chains.
Back to pass, a little bit high once again with the throw. Jones's pass intended for Meath.
The first year, first night of the game, first week of the season, Jones did the same thing. All of his balls, quick outs, and he's not a great passer, but he does have some tone on the ball. But all of his balls are high, which means his elbow is so low that the ball goes high. And when we watch him here, you'll see that. Jones. And he hasn't corrected himself.
Jones has completed 39% of his passes this year for 204 yards, two touchdowns, and four interceptions. Pitch left and sealed up nicely. Michael Wright on the stop. Number 10 held his ground very well to haul down Andre Houston for a short gain. About four-yard gain. It'll bring up a third and six situation for the Wolves. Houston, the leading rusher for the Wolves, 377 yards coming into the game, four touchdowns. He averages over 5 yards a carry. So nice per carry average. Jones averages over 5 yards a carry as well. Quick, Jones keeps it. Good fake handoff, but he's going to be a little bit short. He picked up about 4 or 5 on the play before he's hauled down. It'll bring up a fourth and one. They gave him a great spot. But he's inches shy. Bay City contemplating going for it here.
See, unless they can make the quarterback go on the option, then Bay City has no chance to make. They cannot, you're not gonna be able to run the fullback up in there other than you say a sacrifice play, good luck. And you take a little look at this when you're running the option, unless you can run the quarterback, you're not going to be successful. And this is a good call. This is a call on the part of the coach asking for a measurement.
Even though there's no point in it because you had to get to the 30.
Exactly. But the
point he's buying some time on his decision.
Yeah,
it's basically a timeout.
You're settling your kids down.
He knows he's short. It does look like they're going to go for it. Austin Jones went and got the play, and he comes back in. So a risky move here for Bay City Central, but probably figuring, what do I got to lose? He really wants to maintain ball control.
Exactly. Move those chains.
So here we go. Big play here in this ball game early on. Jones will keep it. Dive ahead. He's got the first down. Kind of hesitated and then dove through the hole. Picked up the 1 yard gain, which is all he needed. And Bay City Central moves the chains. Midland defensive front starting today. Number 36, Brady Harbrin. Number 72, Steve Elmer. The senior who is headed for Notre Dame next year. Number 63, Colin Gagne. Number 53, Terrence Thomas. Make up that front wall for the Chemics defensive line. First and 10 Wolves. Jones back to pass. Try that same play with the same result. They've tried the same pass play three times, that little out to Meath, and he's overthrown him on all three occasions.
High on all three. I'm going to bet that most of his receptions are middle of the field type of receptions as opposed to out patterns, simply because of the elbow.
Yeah. Midland High's linebacking crew, number 25, Tyler Sove, had a great game last week against Mount Pleasant. Number 2, Cody Meyer, making his first start at linebacker. And number 26, Scott Naples, in at linebacker. Midland High Chemic linebacker corps is banged up right now. Jones keeps it, and he's brought down quickly. Looks like Meyer and Naples in on the play.
Cody Meyer on the tackle.
Bring up a third and 10. Cody Meyer mentioned making his first start. Logan Medill injured his knee in the Mount Pleasant game. He's unfortunately maybe out for the year. And Michael Alexander has also got banged up against Arthur Hill, and he is out. And so talking to Coach Mettner, he says, hey, just an opportunity for some guys to step up and see what they can do.
I thought he was a great player for their defense. He made a lot of big plays and really gave a solid effort in there.
Josh Belletti is in at quarterback, back to pass, and is dropped. He found Meath open. He was going to have to catch it and still pick up a couple of yards, but I think he started running before he caught it and drops it. And this time, Bay City Central will have to punt it away. The Midland High secondary holding true. They are... at safety, number 16, Alex Goodwin. Or number 4, Alex Goodwin. Number 10, Michael Wright. Alec Johnson at cornerback and Thomas Smith at cornerback. It is Johnson back deep to receive this punt. Low snap, and he gets it away, and that is going to be a penalty. Fair catch by Johnson. That's going to be roughing the kicker. Pretty easy call there for the official.
Well, you can see the clock was on. Everybody else up tight. And he really, if he has a better angle, he blocks the kick. It's all about the angle. And the angle is not at the kicker. The angle is about a yard and a half in front of the kicker.
Okay. But he was not a yard and a half in front of the kicker. He took him out clean. And that's a big penalty, 15-yard penalty. Takes it out to the 46, and this is a little bit of that field position shift right here, Coach.
That's exactly. That's a big penalty.
And so Bay City Central will maintain possession.
We used to call that a not too smart penalty.
Not too smart. Definitely not.
We can't hear.
And handoff. Not much doing there. It goes to Brady Harbour, and on the tackle brings down Andre Houston after a 2 yard pickup. Joshua Billett is still in at quarterback for the Wolves. Why do you suppose they make this change, Coach?
I don't know. I think they've lost faith in Jones as a thrower.
He's a dangerous runner. We know that
He's
much.
A very good runner.
Blett back to pass. They sure like that play. This time it's successful.
It's been open every
pass
play.
To Austin
it's
Jones.
Been open. I mean, if you're a coach, you look out there and say, it's open. Now I just have to find the guys that want to catch it.
Well, Billette put that had been over his head. This time Billette puts it on the money for Meath. It'll still be a third and four situation for Bay City Central. So Midland High desperately trying to slam the door here and get that ball back on offense. This time it's a pitch left to Houston. Oh, sheds a tackler, sheds another, and he's going to be off to the races. Andre Houston breaking tackles at the line of scrimmage, then at the linebacker level, and then he just explodes down the left sideline and puts the Wolves on the scoreboard. Wow. That came out of the blue there on a third down. Quick pitch to him, and Houston takes it the distance. That's his sixth touchdown on the season. Thomas Jacobs with the extra point attempt for Bay City Central, and it is true. And with 3:35 remaining in the first quarter, Bay City Central strikes first and goes on top 7-0. The penalty looming large on that Bay City Central able to keep the possession, and they've made the Chemics pay. And so Midland High will get the ball back here late in the first quarter. The I mentioned the starters here for Midland, their offensive line at the center position, number 55, Austin Rapanis. Left guard is number 51, Manny Hall. Right guard, number 66, Nick Aide. Right tackle, number 72, Stephen Elmer, who is a big boy, that is for sure, over 300 pounds. And left tackle, number 56, Jacob Dostal. Pat in the running back, Williams at flanker. The fullback is number 48, Cam Short, tight end. Number 11, Austin Ear. We mentioned Ryan Singer is a wideout, and of course, Johnson is the quarterback. And so here we go, Bay City Central, squib kick, and oh, it goes off the Midland defender, and Bay City Central will recover. I don't think that was his intent.
I know that wasn't his
intent. I think
he
missed the ball, really.
He missed the ball, and the offensive guy from Midland missed the ball.
He missed the ball back, and he kind of started to go back to get in position to block, and it just bounced off his leg. Unfortunate break for the Chemics, and just like that, the defense is back on the field being called to slam the door here on Bay City Central.
Now, this is Ooh. Typically a spot where Bay City Central throws for the touchdown.
Well, at this point, I'm not sure who's going to be quarterback because Billette is out there. But so is Jones, although they've been known to throw it to Jones on occasion as well. So the Midland High crowd here stunned early on. BC Central takes a timeout. They took a little too much time trying to decide their personnel, I think, on that one. So you mentioned special teams plays. Most of the time, they go in Midland High's favor, but here early on, the special teams have favored Bay City Central, at least in this case. And it was more by mistake than anything else.
Well, that and, you know, you have excellent extra point. You know, you're able to come back out, and make the play go, but the punt, Bay City Central's had two good punts.
So here we go, first and 10. It is Billette at quarterback. He goes back to pass, he's looking deep, just like you called it, to Jones. He hits him in stride. A good grab by Jones.
Sometimes that was what we just have to know what the other coach likes to do.
Yeah, and he was lined up.
And that's exactly what the other coach likes to do.
He was on the right flanker. He just ran straight down the middle of the field. Bellett put it just a hair too far. He was able to haul it down as he was stumbled forward. But a huge gain for Bay City Central all the way down to the 18-yard line. You called that one, Coach. This time it's a pitch to Houston, and Naples hauls him down after about a 3-yard gain.
Andre Houston on the third.
They'll bring up a second and eight.
We'll see if Bay City Central has patience to go 3 yards, 3 yards, 3 yards, 3 yards, as opposed to what they've done so far.
Some big plays.
Now remember, the running quarterback is not in there.
But he is split out to the left. And he's looking for him in the corner. And he throws in it just through the arms. Pretty good coverage there by Thomas Smith. I think distracted him just enough. A nice pass by Bellett. Really could have been caught. Went right through his arms. But Bay City Central changing things up and going with a more sure arm of Bellett and trying to use Jones's speed, getting him out in space as a receiver.
You see, I don't mind that pass, but we're talking 3 yards, we're talking 14 points on the board. Don't take away your 14 points. Now it's third and eight. You know, as opposed to third and four or third and five. Midland has to stop the running back, Houston,
right,
3 or 4 yards every time. So it's when you play Midland, you can't get greedy. You'd like to get greedy.
Yeah.
But you can't get greedy.
Yeah, so that was close. You got to give credit to Smith on that. That was good coverage. They forced a perfect play on their part, and they weren't able to pull it off. But you're right. Now it ends up being a third and eight instead of trying to just work your way down the field.
Well, this is a big play right here. This is a very big play. And Jones is back in at quarterback, I think.
No, I think that's Bellett still there. Jones is split out to the left. Here we go. Bellett changing the play at the line. Pitch to Houston. Tries to find Barry's ahead. He's going to be short. Sove and Naples in on the stop. And it's going to bring up a fourth down situation. Looks like fourth and two.
Houston had the perimeter. Houston could have made the first down, but he turned it up. And you have a choice. You're either going to turn it up or you're going to run to the sideline. Had he run to the sideline, he'd have gotten the first down.
Well, he was thinking, I don't have far to go for the first. I'm just going to try to burrow my way through. But with just under 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter, fourth and two for Bay City Central. The Chemics need a big stand. Jones is going to keep it. He's got the first, and he's going to take it into the end zone. He found the hole on the right side and then just turned on the burners into the end zone. And just like that, 13-0 Bay City Central.
Remember earlier I was talking about running the option. And you can't run the option unless you've made the decision that the quarterback is going to be the trigger man. And that is a classic case right there, the quarterback being the trigger man.
Thomas Jacobs with the extra point is up and it is good. And with 1:45 remaining in the first quarter, it is Bay City Central 14, Midland nothing. This homecoming crowd here is stunned a little bit. And Bay City Central has got some mojo going right now. We had mentioned before, you know, Midland 5-0 coming in, Bay City Central 2-3, but this longtime rivalry, Bay City Central just always plays Midland tough.
They do. They do. And remember I talked about the idea of the letdown, no matter how much you'd like. That was such a big win last week. And sometimes you say to yourself, all right, maybe I left my game in the locker room for half. and maybe I just got to start playing a little bit better. But yeah. Again, the punt,
right,
hitting the kicker was a crucial mistake.
Changed momentum
of Midland.
Yeah, you're talking about last week, Midland with an epic 41-34 win over Mount Pleasant to really take control of the race for the Saginaw Valley League title in the north. And just an unbelievable ball game. And yeah, Bay City Central didn't read any press clippings coming into this. They said, hey, you're going to be in for a game. And so they will kick off again. Naples and Sove back deep to receive. This time a long kickoff.
In the end zone.
Hauled into the end zone. Automatic touchback if you catch the ball in the end zone. And so Midland High will take over from the 20. Excuse me, that was Travis Patton on the kickoff return. Couldn't see the number there at first.
Yes, Dave, you think about those two kick plays, the block of the hitting the kicker and then the muffed kickoff.
Mm-hmm.
You've got yourself a ball game now.
So Midland has offense has not been on the field much here in the first quarter. Alec Johnson in the shotgun. Back to pass. Sees Singer. He's got Singer. Singer drives ahead. Oh, tremendous effort by Ryan Singer. He's going to pick up the first down. He was going to be held 2 or 3 yards short, and he said, I'll have none of that. He just kept spinning and churning, and Singer picks up the first down.
You know, sometimes, Dave, you have to understand it. So there are quarterbacks and receivers that are in tone with each other, and Johnson and Singer are in tone with each other.
That's a great point. You can tell he has confidence in throwing to Singer.
He has confidence in him. And
pitch to Patton. Patton eludes one tackler, cuts up field. Oh, big tackle. Nice job by number 50, Ryan Conger. And he's going to hold him to about a 2-yard pickup. Patton looked like he may have some room to run, but a tremendous tackle. Patton comes into the game today with 428 yards rushing, 6 touchdowns, averaging 4.5 yards per carry. Be 2nd and 8 for the Chemics. We're in the last minute of the first quarter. Patton, the lone setback. Johnson fakes the handoff. He's going to keep it. Spins ahead out to the 36-yard line. He's still going to need 5 yards for the first down. It'll be 3rd and 5. And you mentioned Johnson, a 4-way threat.
5-way threat.
5-way threat?
Quad threat.
I don't want to cut him short or anything.
He's a quad threat to me.
Johnson has run for 216 yards on the year, 6.4 yards per carry. Tremendous average for a quarterback. 2 touchdowns. Back to pass. He's got a man open. That's going to be a first down for the Chemics. Thomas Smith on the reception. He was wide open. Nice touch by Johnson, just kind of plopping it into him, and Smith takes it up for the first down as the first quarter ends.
And I see that formation right there against Bay City Central, straight man-to-man, is going to be open anytime they want. It's called a bunch. They're all together, and they just separate. And so the result is, against the man-to-man, there are all kinds of things called rubs and bumps and picks. Mm-hmm. And
you know what you call those?
I call them wraps.
Yeah, wraps.
Route altering patterns. But I love rub better now. You know, that's the new term for it. But
sounds more legal.
Yeah, it sounds a lot more legal than just go out and pick them. You know, and we used to have a play called picket fence where everybody just picks. And that's exactly what happened there. That was a picket fence play where everybody picked everybody and it was wide open in the flat. And you get your easy first downs that way.
Yeah, I get the sense that short passing game just may be there frequently here tonight for the Chemics. Johnson, quick bubble screen to Ear, and he's going to get about 6 or 7 yards on the play. We'll call it 7. Well-designed play, good blocking in front of Ear. As the tight end was split out wide to the right, he came back towards the quarterback for the pass and had two blockers in front of him. It will be a 6-yard pickup out to the 50-yard line, ball resting right at midfield.
That play is called a jailbreak screen, and defenses are getting so much better at defending against it.
You can see it coming.
Well, you know the angles that you have to get to it.
Second and four. Williams has it, breaks outside. He's got quick feet. Oh, what a move. Still on his feet. Oh, my goodness, what a run. Wow, that's an exciting run by Will Williams. You can't even say he broke tackles. He just left people in his wake.
He has some giddy up to it.
Well, he's got, you can tell right there, the ability to stop and get going. Stop, change direction, and it's almost like he doesn't stop. He's the defender's grasping at air. It's first down, Chemics at the 31. Faked it that time. Patton behind a big block. Burrows ahead. Good blocking up front from Elmer. And also 56 out there, Jacob Dostal, leading the charge for a 6-yard gain.
See, I think Midland has a lot of weapons. But to me, as a coach, I want Will Williams to touch the ball 20 times.
Speed kills.
Well, he's not only speed, he's so shifty.
Johnson will keep it. Tries to get away. He broke one tackle and just could not quite break the grasp of Stone Manzek. Manzek, number 54, looks like a pretty good ball player out there. He's made some big defensive plays here in the early going. It'll bring up a 3rd and 3 for the Chemics from their Bay City Central 24. Midland down 14-0 here with 10 minutes to go in the second quarter.
This is a very good drive right here.
Full house backfield for the Chemics. Handoff to Williams. And he is going to be a little short, I believe. Tried to run him with the power game. Just wasn't quite able to get enough. He's going to pick up 2, but it's going to bring up 4th and 1. Huge play for the Chemics. They're going to be going for it here.
Well, this is Patton behind the fullback.
4th and 1. Chemics want to keep this drive alive. Put the 2 fullback set in front of Patton. Handoff, Patton got the first down, still on his feet, drives ahead. First down, Chemics, all the way down to the 13-yard line.
Well, you just have to love the fact that he puts his feet in there and keeps them moving.
Patton would not be denied, and even when he got the first down, if you let up defensively, he's going to make you pay. Here's another look at it, going behind those 2 fullbacks. Initial contact right there, and he gains about 7 yards after
exactly
the initial contact.
Exactly what happened on the winning touchdown last week. He broke the tackle at the line of scrimmage and was gone.
Patton again driving ahead. This time Manzek on the stop again. And he's going to be held for no gain.
Manzek for Bay City Central makes a lot of tackles.
He does.
Not only does he make tackles, but he also disrupts blocking. So it's somebody else. I mean, he's an excellent defensive player.
He makes tackles with authority.
Yeah.
If he makes the contact, you're probably not going any farther. 2nd and 10. Singer out to the left. Smith in the slot. Now he goes in motion. Fakes the handoff. Oh, a little counter to Patton. Spins, drives, touchdown, Chemics. Oh, what a play. They faked the handoff to the man in motion and then countered back with Patton, found a hole, and then he just spun, ran, and drove away into the end zone. Tremendous run by Patton. And the Chemics are on the board. Wow, just like you talked about that last play. He just was not going to be denied.
He runs hard. He never stops moving his feet. That's a mark of a great back.
Ryan Singer with the extra point, booms it, and just like that, Midland cuts Bay City Central's lead in half. It is now 14-7 with 8 minutes and 14 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Let's take another look at that touchdown run by Travis Patton. Well, no, that was the previous play. Didn't get a, maybe we'll later we can get another look at that one, but well conceived play for that touchdown play. Enough deception to throw off the defense, and then great execution on the part of the offensive line and the running back.
It was really a good series for Midland. Very diversified, enough running to keep you honest and enough passing to free up the first downs.
And so here we go. Here's a look at it. Look at that, Patton, spinning.
Good spin.
Driving.
Good run.
Touchdown. Mm.
Excellent job.
Patton, his seventh rushing touchdown on the season. Boy, those last two plays, just gotta love the effort. And so Ryan Singer teed up at the 40-yard line. East City Central awaiting the kick. A high, kind of short. Ball's gonna hit, and it is received and taken out to about the 24-yard line. Can't quite see who was on the return there. I think it was Houston, actually.
Basie Central was very lucky to get that ball.
Yeah, the bounce went their way.
The bounce went their way, exactly.
The bounce is back.
There was nobody else.
It's anybody's.
There was nobody there where he hit it. He hit a perfect kick.
Was by design, that
pop-up.
That pop-up kick. Right. Midland has run that for years with great success. First and 10, Basie Central from their 24. Hand off to the fullback. That's Rutledge, Tarquin Rutledge. Spins ahead and picks up a couple. I think Harbrin was in on that tackle for the Chemics. That'll be second and 8. Midland would love just to get a 3-and-out right here and get that ball back. Here's a pitch to Houston to the right side. Oh, a quick move, still on his feet. Drives ahead. And another impressive run by Houston, brought down finally by Goodwin. His running style reminiscent of Patton's, actually. Just kind of quick feet and just keep driving ahead until somebody tackles you.
He's got good sized thighs and strong upper body.
Bring up 3rd and 1 for Bay City Central. 7 minutes remaining in the second quarter. Handoff, and it's close. Oh, great defensive stand. Michael Wright, but I think he's gonna get it. Devon Jackson was stood up by Wright, but he didn't need much. He didn't get much, but just enough to get the first down and move the chains while resting at the 35-yard line. Good play by Wright right there. Once he made contact, he
for
basically
Central, back. This is exactly what they want to do. Run the clock, keep it going, make first downs, hope for a break.
Back to pass, the ball's tipped.
Those are not the things basically Central wants to do right there.
Goodwin dove, tried to get the interception. It's they went back with Austin Jones at quarterback. I'm a little surprised because they moved the ball very well with Billett calling the signals. They tried that out pattern again and unsuccessfully again.
The results show everything.
And so Meath split up the left. Fakes the handoff, or no, he's hands off to the fullback. Minimal gain. Play looked like it was disrupted a little bit on the handoff.
Well, if you take a look on the last two plays, the quarterback has tripped, but has been tripped by the charging lineman of the Chemics. So you got to take a look at that right there. I mean, they're just basically Central's offensive line has their hands full right now. They cannot run the ball inside the tackles. The best play they have is a run the option with the quarterback keeping.
Well, it is 3rd and 9, and Billette is back in. I'm going to guess we're not going to get the option here. But Jones is in the slot. It's a reverse to Jones. He is going to run the ball. He's got some room to run. A blocker in front of him. Cuts it back up. Still on his feet. Finally knocked out of bounds. But not before he gets into Chemic territory. All the way down to the 46-yard line. Great play call by the Wolves.
This is a point that, you know, Jones is such a good runner that, you know, and just his keeping the ball on the option is going to get them out. Here comes the replay on this. This is a great play, and really could have gone for nothing because you see the Midland guy is not fooled, and he gets out into the perimeter. Now Jones is running pretty strong and gets a full head of steam.
Jones back in at quarterback. Pitch to Houston, cuts it back up. He drives ahead, still on his feet. Boy, he's a strong runner. Goodwin on the tackle. Houston's going to pick up about 6 on the play.
Alex Goodwin, Cody Meyer on the tackle.
Meyer also in on the stop. For the Chemics, it'll be 2nd and 4.
See, if I'm Bay City Central, I'm not running the ball anywhere inside. And right now, every play they've run from the tackle out has gotten positive yards. Any play they run from the tackle in has gotten negative yards.
Jones keeps. This time he is smothered. Brady Harbrin would have none of that. Great defensive play by Harbrin. Have to give him a yard on that one. It'll be 3rd and a long 2. You know, we'll make it, call it 3rd and 3 from the 39. Jones at quarterback. It's going to be the pitch to Houston. Cuts back up again, and he is hit near the chains. I think he's going to be short.
2 yards short.
Good defensive stand by the Chemics. A host of blue jerseys there to meet him. Sove and Goodwin on the stop, leading the charge, and it'll bring up 4th and 2. That play has been very successful for Bay City Central. This time,
it is successful.
Midland sniffed it out.
Without blocking. I mean, there's nobody going to block the outside linebacker. And they're very successful running that play one-on-one. It's an old BYOB play, be your own blocker. And so you get out there and you say, okay, you've got to avoid one person. And for the most part, Houston has done that.
BC Central will call timeout. That's their 3rd of the half, the 3rd and final one of the half. Fans, you're watching this Bay City Central Midland High homecoming game on MPS-TV 98 in Midland. This game will be cable cast on the following dates and times. It's Friday night, September 28th at midnight. Saturday, September 29th at 1 p.m. and 11 p.m. And you can see on the screen, Sunday, September 30th through Thursday, October 4th at 1 p.m. and 9. For more dates and times to follow, check the Midland Public Schools website at www.mps.k12.mi.us, as you can see on your screen. And next week, the MCTV volunteers and staff will bring you the Dow High homecoming game, and then we'll also bring you the Midland Dow game on October 19th. So 4th and 2, Bay City Central. And pitches it to Houston. He's going to still on his feet. Oh, he breaks free, and he's going to get the first down. Oh, the play was messed up from the beginning, and he got the pitch to Houston. The defense was there, and Houston
breaks tackles.
He does. He's a nice runner.
He's got strong legs. We're going to see where he gets hit. See how he got hit in the shoulders, and he just broke the tackle and gets through.
That's a huge play in this ball game. Midland High hoping to get the ball back with there's just over 3 minutes to go. They would have plenty of time to take it down, but now Bay City Central is going to really, they're in scoring position here as this half winds down. Hand off to the fullback, still on his feet, hit hard. after a two-yard gain. That is, looks like Cameron Short on the tackle.
Well, they ran a little fullback trap in there, bringing the guard across the block, and the trapper got stuck in the backfield, and the fullback realized what happened and broke it to the outside. Good play by the fullback, good play by Midland to come up and make the stop.
Second and nine, 2.5 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Back to pass is Jones, he's going deep. That's great coverage by the Chemics. Elk Johnson on the coverage. He tried to find Meath, who is obviously his favorite receiver, but he was blanketed. Not much chance of that being completed. Bring up a third and nine.
There was good defense, but even with that good defense, the pass was not going to, it's an overthrow.
And so this time, Billette will come back in at quarterback. They just seem to run more efficiently when he's in there, and they use Jones
as a receiver
or a runner.
Or a runner, right.
But I guess, you know, you mix it up and you keep the defense guessing.
See, Johnson is now on Jones.
Blatt back to pass. Get the out and drop. That was to Jones. And he just plain dropped it.
He got too fancy. He got too fancy. Did a little jumpy, little jump hop, and all you do is
just catch
run
it and
under
turn
the ball and
the
turn.
Down.
Yeah, he got a little fancy.
Ball was there by Billette.
I'd run the same play again.
Billette hasn't thrown much. He was only 3 for 10 for 69 yards and a touchdown coming in.
He hasn't thrown
today.
A bad pass tonight.
No.
Not a bad pass.
Well, 4th and 9 to go here. 2:15 remaining in the second quarter.
Shotgun.
Huge play. Houston in the backfield. He fakes the handoff. Billette looks downfield. Goes to the end zone for Jones, and it is
out of bounds.
Incomplete. Oh boy, it was that close. He just he probably needed to throw the ball just about a step earlier. But in waiting that much longer, it forced Jones too close to the sidelines. He hauls it in, but he was out of bounds. Wow, Midland escaped with that one. Let's take another look at it. He was going to Jones all the way, rolling to the left. Beautiful pass. Definitely out of bounds. Good call by the official.
On the money.
Right on the money. Just needed to do it a step earlier. So Midland now. 2:07 remaining in the half is going to try to march down. They're down by 7. Had a good drive last time they had the ball. Dumps it to Williams. There's a flag on the play.
Usually that flag is illegal procedure by a wideout.
We'll take a look at it. It was about a 8-yard pickup, and they are bringing it back. That ineligible receiver downfield.
I think that's illegal. That's eligible receiver downfield.
Wow.
That's a nasty penalty.
That, especially on a that was a quick pass.
A quick
play.
Pass, and
you don't see that called very often.
Unless there was somebody covered up, and two receivers went out, that would might be the answer there. Two on the same side, and one was both on the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, nevertheless, it's going to bring up a 1st and 15. Johnson back to pass. And he throws it, intercepted. He's still on his feet. The flag comes flying in. It's picked off by Brady Draves.
Now,
really an ill-advised pass.
Not only that, Will Williams is wide open. That if we get a replay on that, we'll be able to see that. Will Williams is wide open right down the seam.
But there, yeah, it's a penalty on the return. So basically Central will retain possession after the interception. They will have the ball at the 28-yard line. Let's take another look at it.
Here comes the replay, and we'll see that, you know, this is. Yeah, right in the center. Got right into the little hook zone, and the ball pops up.
He just didn't see.
No, he didn't see the other guys.
A rare mistake by Johnson, only his second interception on the season. And with 1:43 remaining, Bay City Central tried to make Midland pay here. Blatt rolls to his left. He's going with that same play, and this time it is incomplete. Johnson on the coverage. He tried the same play that worked on fourth down the previous possession. And great coverage by Johnson this time. Another well-thrown ball.
What I say, Johnson is an excellent defender. Yep. I mean, that's, you put Johnson on two and you say, okay, I'm going to cover you.
So second and 10, 1:37 remaining in the half. I'm not sure this is the last time we'll see Blatt try to find number five out there. Oh, there was a flag on the play. That was a legal procedure.
There's a flag on the play.
So actually no play. It'll be first and 15. Yeah, see, Midland's gonna decline it. So it'll be bring up second and 10. Yeah, I was gonna say.
I was kind of surprised.
Yeah, they marched it off, kind of assuming. But Coach Eric Mettner obviously wanting them to use up the down. Second and 10, Blatt in the shotgun. Houston standing next to him. High snap, fakes the handoff. Blatt's gonna keep it. And not much doing there. Tyler Solve in on the stop along with Goodwin.
The entire play was messed up by the snap.
Midland sniffing that out quickly. Maybe even lost a little bit, but we'll call it third and 10. Clock is running.
All I have to do is find five. You know it's gonna be a pass, and you know it's gonna go to him.
1 minute left in the half. Blatt back to pass, looking for him, and he's open. Austin Jones on the reception. Yep, you knew that's the guy he's looking for.
He only has eyes for him. He might be the only guy who can catch. I mean, really, you have to say, I can't tell you the number of times quarterbacks, I'd ask him, why'd you throw to him? He says, Coach, he can't catch. You just come flat out and tell me he can't catch.
Actually, Jones did not get the first down. It's he's just short.
Oh,
it's gonna,
that's a surprise.
It's fourth down.
Because I thought he ran for the stick. He ran for the stick. I'm surprised at that mark.
Because he ran out of bounds, didn't he?
Right. So he ran right at the stick.
He ran short of it, though. So it's fourth in inches. Blatt's going to keep it. I don't know. It's going to depend on the spot. Defense rose. They knew. It's like they sensed that play was coming.
I think he made it.
It looked like he got a pretty good spot right there.
Yeah.
Boy, he did not get much surge. They're going to bring the chains out.
They're going to mark it. Yeah.
All about the spot on a play like that. Huge, huge spot, too. Fourth and inches. 49 seconds to go in the half. Stretch the chains and
Midland.
Short. Oh, the Chemic defense stiffens. Wow, they caught a break on that
third
down play.
Here's the thing.
If you're
going to run,
a
quarterback sneak, it's got to be five. You know, Blatt has not shown the ability to run the ball anywhere, and Jones is a hard nosed.
Yeah,
up and down runner.
But they got a break on 30.
Yeah,
ran out of bounds short of the first down, and they try the sneak, and Midland holds. So huge play for the Chemics.
I am shocked that he didn't get a first down.
Singer and Williams split to the left. Johnson's going deep over the middle, looking for Williams, and incomplete. double coverage back there. Jones and Balot, we mentioned their names a lot offensively. They make the play on defense this time. They try to go big on the post pattern to Williams, trying to utilize that speed, but great coverage by the secondary. Second and 10 for the Chemics. Williams and Singer again split out wide to the left. Thomas Smith out to the right. Patton is the setback. It'll go to Patton. He's got a hole. He's on his feet. He breaks it outside to the left. Cuts back up. Still on his feet. Finally runs out of bounds near midfield. Huge gain for the Chemics. Big hole for Patton. He burst through it and then just uses those quick feet. Exactly. And a great run to get out of bounds and stop the clock.
Not only is he a strong runner, but he's so quick. His feet are just dancing.
Low snap brought up, and just look at that hole. And then he did not get touched, breaking through there.
And right there, he makes a little move that got him another 9 yards.
Johnson back to pass. He's got Williams wide open down the right side. Makes a move, and he gets hauled down at the 19-yard line. So that short pass play, and then Williams turns on the burners. Did not get out of bounds, however. Midland High will call timeout. That's their first of three in the half, 25 seconds left.
I am convinced that Williams would have evaded the two guys in front of him. It was the linebacker that came racing up behind the tackle.
Oh, yeah.
He would have gotten away from the two guys in front of him. And they'd have wondered, he reminds me of, I'll tell you what he reminds me of. And I thought this last week. The Roadrunner against Wile E. Coyote. I am not kidding you. I'm looking at him.
Wow.
And I keep thinking, okay, the defensive guy's going to have a safe fall on him. I mean, because, you know, it's just, he's like a Roadrunner out
beep,
there.
Beep, and then
beep, beep, and I'll see you later.
A cloud dust behind.
He's the Roadrunner. And everybody else on the other team is Wile E. Coyote. They're just not going to tackle him.
Oh, man. That's a good one. That's a good one. Well, Midland High, after what a turn of events right here, Coach. Midland High was on the brink of falling down behind two touchdowns, make a big stand. Now two big plays, and just like that, they are knocking on the door here late
in
the half.
See, this is wide open over here on the left side. It's two on two. Two on two, no problem. Right
Johnson.
Now, get it to Williams.
Finds Williams.
There
he's got
it. Is.
Cuts up field, driving ahead, and all the way down to the 1 yard line. This time showing some power in his run.
Right now, you just say to yourself, okay, they cannot stop us. In that look right there, they cannot stop. It's two on two, and our two are better than your two. And my quarterback can deliver the ball. See, it's two on two out here. So all Williams did was make a little out, break out, and there's nobody there.
Mm, look at that.
This is going to be a touchdown.
So Midland calls timeout. Their second of the half. There's 17.5 seconds remaining.
Outstanding drive.
The drive started with
143.
Yeah, with 43 seconds.
143.
143. It was less than a minute, wasn't it?
If you think so, I don't know.
I thought it was.
I thought it was 143, but.
Nevertheless, impressive drive, and Williams on those last two plays showing some outstanding athleticism. And you got to like Johnson bouncing back. He made that through the interception only a second of the year, and then he made a couple of nice plays on defense, and then now he's just engineered this drive all the way down to the one.
He throws a pass that's easy to catch. You know, it has nice tone on it. It doesn't overpower you. It doesn't float over you. It's just a nice, easy to catch ball.
You know what you like about Johnson? He's the guy that makes the mistake, and then instead of pouting, he's like, well, I'm going to make up for
it. He turns the page.
That's right.
He forgets it.
He just turns the page and forgets it. Power backfield for the Chemics. It's Patton driving ahead and in for the touchdown.
Terrific.
Midland Chemics with 14 seconds to go in the half. Score on Patton's second touchdown of the evening. Oh, man, what a way to end the half. And Singer will line up for the extra point. Smith is his holder. He'll be trying to tie things up here. Snap is good. The kick is good. There's going to be offsides on Bay City Central. They should be able to decline that, shouldn't they? Or do they have to kick it again?
No, you have to take the penalty.
All right. They might not want to mark up the yardage. No, they're going to. Yeah, it's just they're not. They don't want that. You don't need it any closer. So Singer will line up to do it again. Snap is good. Hold is good. Kick is up, and it is good. And Midland High on a tremendous drive in the final minute ties things up. We'll take a look at the touchdown once again.
Very powerful.
That full house backfield that they love to employ in short yardage situations. He just follows the two leaders, puts his head down, drives ahead through the hole behind Stephen Elmer and his other blockers. Nathan Fisher, 44, one of those fullbacks. And wow, what an exciting first half of football.
Absolutely.
A lot of twists and turns, changes in momentums, big plays by both teams.
This is the best I've seen Bay City Central this year.
I like their.
This is the best I've seen them. I mean, I'm not taking anything away from anybody else they've played, but this is the best they've played.
I like with Billette at quarterback and then get him deliver the ball. They look dangerous in that when they go with that lineup. Singer will kick off. I'd be surprised if you see one of those pooches right here.
Yeah,
try to take a chance on getting possession.
Between the 30 and the 10. I agree.
Ooh, a little onside. It's ball's free. I think Bay City Central recovers it. It's a good idea, really, by Midland High. What do you have to lose with now 12 seconds remaining? If you get the ball, you take a chance downfield.
Take one strike, right?
And we'll see if Bay City Central tries to do that. I think we'll know by whoever's in at quarterback. And it looks like Jones is going to come in. See if they take a knee or maybe try to run that option and try to make a big play out of it. Houston, obviously an able runner. If he gets out in open field, he can do some damage. And they do run that pitch to him. Oh, it's going to be a pass. He's looking downfield, throws it up, and it's caught by Jones. A little trickeration there. And they still have time, 4 seconds remaining. Thrown to Jones, brought down by Meyer. So 4 seconds left. I'm kind of surprised they don't put Billette in there and air it out.
Exactly.
Oh, they're going to spike it, and that's what they're thinking. Spike it with 2 seconds, and now I think we'll see that change. Yeah, we'll see Jones streaking on a post or the flag pattern, and Billette will try to get it to him. Alec Johnson needs to be on his toes right here. He's playing a deep safety. He and Goodwin.
This is a perfect time for a screen. Absolutely
the safeties
perfect. Safeties
playing
are
20,
back.
At least 20 yards
you've got
off
a runner,
the scrimmage.
You've got a runner who can handle it in Houston. It's a perfect time for a screen pass.
Blatt back to pass. Throws it up for Jones, and it is, batted down. Goodwin batted it down. Kind of popped up, actually, momentarily, and they took another swat at it. And the clock runs out. We go to halftime, tied 14-0. Take another look at that last Hail Mary play. As you know, predicted, they just tried to chuck it up. You got way too much air under it. And good coverage by the Chemics.
Very good coverage. There's
Williams
the
also
pop.
Back there. Yeah,
that's
good job
a good
by Goodwin.
Play by Goodwin.
Once
Absolutely.
It popped up, he stayed with it and left no doubt. And so we will be sending it down to the field for the halftime festivities for this homecoming game. Again, it's Midland 14, Bay City Central 14. The Midland High Marching Band about to take the field, and we'll also bring you all the other homecoming festivities. So we'll send it down to the field. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the Midland High School Marching Band.
Under the direction of Mr. William Monroe, Mrs. Kathy Peretz, and Mrs. Cheryl Martini, with instrumental specialists Judith Peterson and Roger Stevens, it's the Midland High School Chemic Marching Band, featuring drum majors James Miller, Audrey Ortiz, Kate Kiekhafer, and Brianna Spencer. The Chemic Band will now play the Chemic Fight Song. Band, are you ready? Pom-Pom Squad are under the direction of Ms. Tracy Hall. This award-winning group is an outstanding addition to this season's halftime shows. The Chemic Band and Pom-Pom Squad will now perform a hit song from a couple years back, Love Drunk. School District is fortunate to have a wonderful music program at each of our middle schools. Tonight, the Northeast Middle School Band, under the direction of Mr. Roger Stevens, the Central Middle School Band, under the direction of Chris O'Connell, and the St. John's Middle School Band, under the direction of Ms. Alicia Bonnert, will all join the Chemic Marching Band for your halftime entertainment. Enjoy the great music of all these bands on the field as they perform the theme from Rocky. Selection. Here is Mambo Jumbo. I'd like to thank Mr. Jeff Jaster, principal at Northeast Middle School, Mr. Steve Poole, principal at Central Middle School, and John Pickleman, principal at St. John's Middle School, for the wonderful support they give to the music students in their schools. We would also like to thank the directors for their help in making this evening a success. Midland has a fine music program that allows students to enjoy the great opportunities that music affords them throughout their lives. To all of you on this evening, thanks for being a Chemic. The 2012 Homecoming Parade, organized by the Chemic Chapter of the National Honor Society, featured the theme, Dr. Seuss. This year, we welcome Mr. Bob Lanning as our Grand Marshal. Also known as Bobby the Chemic, he has been an admirable supporter of Midland High School for many years and is a proud Chemic himself. He's a graduate of the class of 1957 and was a member of the very first MHS swim team. He has earned his nickname over the years as he has attended almost every Chemic football game since 1988 and runs the scoreboard at our home baseball games. Bobby exemplifies what Chemic Pride is all about. His school spirit lives on, and for that reason, he is the perfect Grand Marshal for this year's homecoming celebration. Judging the parade entries this year were Dr. Ginny Donald, Mr. Ted Zook, and Mr. Mike McKenna. Dr. Donald retired from MHS in 2007 after teaching for 25 years and serving as the Social Studies Department Head and Student Council Advisor. Mr. Zook retired from MHS in July 2012 and enjoys woodworking, crafting, and gardening. Mr. McKenna also retired at the end of the last school year after 30 years of service and enjoys playing the guitar and the banjo. The National Honor Society and all Chemics thank our Grand Marshal and judges for their efforts and contributions to our 2012 Dr. Seuss Homecoming Parade. The entries from this year's parade are being represented this evening by members of the National Honor Society. This year's walking entries included the orchestra, who led the Grinch's sleigh through the parade, and the National Art Honor Society, whose members each painted their own favorite scene or character from Dr. Seuss on canvas and carried it in the parade. After much deliberation, the judges decided that both entries were outstanding and awarded a tie for first place to both groups. Congratulations to both the orchestra and NAHS. This year's float entries included the freshman class, whose float represents Horton Hears a Who. They included the face of Horton and also represented Midland by including Dow Diamond in the tridge. The sophomore class, whose float is here to show you a fun time with the Cat in the Hat. The junior class, whose float represents the story of the Grinch with how the Chemics stole the game. And the senior class, who represented the story of the Lorax by painting actual pages from the book on the sides of their float. And now for the judges' decisions for the floats. In third place, the sophomores. In second place, the juniors. And in first place, the seniors. Congratulations to all of our walking and float entries, and thank you for all of your hard work. And now, the moment you have all been waiting for, our 2012 Homecoming Court. Please welcome our principal, Janet Greif, escorted by seniors Gretchen Holzhauer and Justine Miller. The first of our freshman representatives, Amanda Johnson, is escorted by her parents, Paul and Linda Johnson. At Northeast, Amanda was involved with Viking leadership. At Midland High, she is a member of the newly formed book club. She is also involved in Key Club and the Environmental Club. Amanda actively volunteers in the community and recently participated in the Tall in the Saddle horseback program. The second of our freshman representatives, Connor Babin, is escorted by his parents, Jeff and Katie Babin. Connor currently is a member of Midland High's JV tennis team. In previous years, he has participated in track, football, and the Community Center Basketball League. The first of our sophomore representatives, Emma Heron, is escorted by her parents, William and Susan Heron. At Midland High, Emma is involved in BPA, the orchestra, and the Key Club. She is also actively involved in Girl Scouts. The second of our sophomore representatives, Jake Rajeski, is escorted by his parents, Tom and Shelly Rajeski. At Northeast, Jake participated on the football and basketball teams. Here at Midland High, Jake has been on the student council and is a member of the varsity soccer team. The first of our junior representatives, Savannah Wheeler, is escorted by her parents, Scott and Linda Wheeler. Savannah's activities at Midland High include varsity cheerleading, symphony orchestra, soccer, and Big Brothers and Big Sisters. Second of our junior representatives, Levi Box, is escorted by his parents, Brian and Lisa Box. While at Midland High, Levi has been a member of the football, wrestling, and track teams. Our first senior representative is Hannah Fisher. Hannah is being escorted by her parents, JW and Yvonne Fisher. Hannah stays busy serving as the Vice President of Student Council. She is a member of National Honor Society, the Commencement Committee, and is a steering team member for Midland County Youth Leadership. At Midland High, Hannah serves as the team captain for the varsity tennis team. She plans to study psychology at a college out west. The second of our senior representatives, Nick Aide, is escorted by his parents, John and Kim Aide. Nick is a member of the Midland High varsity football team and track team. In the past, Nick was a participant of Midland County Youth Leadership Program. Nick plans to attend Northern Michigan University in the fall of next year to study forensic psychology. Our next senior representative is Haley Moulton. She's being escorted onto the field by her father and stepmother, Troy and Sue Moulton, and her mother and stepfather, Kathy and James Smith. Haley is actively involved in student council, Big Brothers Big Sisters, and the MHS lacrosse team. She has served on the Midland County Youth Leadership Steering Team for the past 3 years. Haley plans to attend Grand Valley in the fall to begin her studies in the medical field. The next senior representative, Dylan Matthews, is being escorted by his parents, Brian and Tammy Matthews. At Midland High, Dylan serves as the student body president and was his class president for 3 years. He's a captain for the varsity soccer team, in which he's been a 3-year starter. Dylan is a member of the National Honor Society and the Commencement Committee. He's had the privilege of being a member of the steering team for Midland County Youth Leadership for the past 3 years. In the community, Dylan is an active member of the Extreme Youth Group. He will be attending Moody Bible Institute in downtown Chicago in the fall. Our final female senior representative is Audrey Ortiz. She is escorted this evening by her parents, Jeff and Julie Ortiz. Audrey is the dance captain for the MHS Drama Club and has performed in numerous productions. In addition, she is the drum major for the marching band and currently serves as the vice president of National Honor Society. Audrey plans to major in chemical engineering at the University of Michigan. Final senior representative is Evan Novak. He's escorted onto the field by his parents, Tyler and Chris Novak. Evan has been a member of the football and track teams during all 4 years of high school. He was a member of the chemic band for 2 years. Evan is actively involved in both the welding and building trades organizations. In Evan's free time, he enjoys sailing, quadding, and off-roading. He will be attending Ferris State in the fall. And finally, the King and Queen of Homecoming 2012, Zoe Bucci and Stephen Elmer. Zoe is escorted this evening by her parents, John and Laurel Bucci. Zoe stays active at Midland High as Secretary of Student Council. In addition, she is a member of National Honor Society and the Commencement Committee. Zoe is actively involved in a variety of school and community events. She is interested in pursuing a career in psychology or social work. Stephen is escorted by his parents, Steve and Jennifer Elmer. Stephen has been a member of the varsity football team for 3 of the past 4 years. He recently received a full athletic scholarship to play football for Notre Dame in the fall. In addition, he has been invited to play in the U.S. Army All-American Bowl. While at Midland High, Stephen was a member of student council in the track team. This past summer, he participated in a mission trip to Scranton, Pennsylvania with the Blessed Sacrament Youth Outreach Team. Congratulations, Chemics. And now, the Midland High School fight song. Community for their support of the Chemic Music Discount Card. We still have cards available if you'd like to purchase one.
Their $10 can be purchased in the Midland High School main office or by getting in contact with an MHS music student or director.
The Chemic Band would also like to invite everyone to our annual marching band exhibition on the evening of Wednesday, October 10th. Bands from all over mid-Michigan will be performing along with your very own Chemic Marching Band. The evening will start at 6 o'clock p.m. and we're going to have a great time. Come out and enjoy some great entertainment.
And we're welcome back, getting ready here for the second half of today's homecoming game. Again, this is Dave Marsh and Frank Aldemore bringing you the action. And Coach, always just got to love the homecoming festivities, the band, the homecoming king and queen and court and everything. Just exciting thing about high
people,
school.
People love homecoming. You know, and I'm really impressed with Midland's homecoming in that they've maintained the traditions that they've had from way in the beginning of the school. But what you look out here is you see the adults that come back for homecoming. It's a very big, big deal at Midland.
And, yeah, definitely a big deal, and you can tell it's just packed here on the home side of the game. We're seeing a great game here in the first half, and we're gonna take a look at some of the highlights from that first half. Again, we're tied up at 14. Going to show some of the replays from that action. And here's Bay City Central early on. And this is just a great run by Houston.
He broke three tackles, Dave, and just powerful run.
It's got to give a guy credit sometimes. I mean, so that right. Got Bay City Central on the scoreboard first, taking that 7-0 lead. And then, as you recall, the kind of they flubbed the kickoff and ends up working to their advantage.
See, those 14 points all came on Midland miscues. So you have to, you know, recognize that important point. And you turn around the next part, and you've got Midland now making a tremendous comeback after those 14 points.
So that was the extra point after that first touchdown. Here's the quarterback slash receiver, Austin Jones, taking that in. They had flubbed the kickoff and recovered it, then marched down. Jones taking it in. And now this is just Travis Patton spinning and driving his way ahead to cut that lead in half to make it 14-7. And then next up, this is another big play by Patton. And just good juking, smart, getting out of bounds. And Midland High had just stopped them on fourth down, made that big play. And then here is Johnson finding Williams on another great play all the way down to the one, deep into the half. There's about 20 seconds to go at that point in time. And then, once again, this is Patton pounding at home. And just like that, we're tied up at 14.
Really a diversified half. You know, just back and forth with Midland coming back from 14 down. You know, 14 down is manageable, but you really don't like to do it. And if you're going to do it, it's got to be the first half.
Yeah, it's significant enough where you start to worry a little bit. But give the Chemics credit. They made the big plays when they had to. And we got a brand new ball game here in the second half. Really both teams kind of played similarly, both with some big runs by their premier running backs and quarterbacks making some nice throws and big plays. Defense, both teams making some big plays. And here we go. Midland will get the ball to receive to open the second half. It'll be Scott Naples will be back along with Patton to receive the kick. And everybody was all lined up and they realized they were going the wrong way. So we'll try this again. Set it up from the other 40. kicking for Bay City Central is Thomas Jacobs. Yeah, as I went down for halftime, kind of chatting with some of the folks out there and looking back, it's just completely full on this side of the stadium. And then you can see a lot of people standing along the fence line and the on top of the stands, too, just hundreds of people up standing to watch the game. Just a great atmosphere. Well, here we go. Jacobs boots it, a squib kick. Goodwin will take it at the 24. Finds a little hole, still on his feet, just to the left, spins all the way out to the 45-yard line. Nice job by Alex Goodwin to set up great field position to start the half for the Chemics. And so the Chemic offense, one thing you got to like about that is it's well balanced. You know, they have a strong running game, and Johnson is a terrific passer. He's got good receivers with sure hands, got some speed. It's a tough offense to contend with.
Again, you got 2x2 out here for Midland, and this should be easy picking. This is Will Williams in the flat.
With a good 10-yard cushion. And there, you called it, Williams in the flat. On his feet, spins, still on his feet, all the way down to the 35-yard line. Electric runner, the road runner. Again, just grabbing that short pass and making a big play out of it.
See, I mean, that's just easy, very easy. And now, on the other side, now you're looking at one-on-one on the wide side of the field with no under coverage. I mean, this is a thing that has to be impressive.
Patton gets the handoff.
That Bay City Central is committing everybody to the run without any under coverage, and they're saying, okay, go ahead and throw the football.
Well, that's basically a run. On those short passes, you just pitch
throw
and catch
the ball. Let Will Williams and let Singler do their thing.
What a 1 yard gain for Patton. The ball rests on the 34-yard line.
Okay, so now Bay City has dropped a man off to get to that flat.
Johnson back to pass. He's got Smith wide open short, driving ahead. And he's going to get another Chemic first down.
Okay, so that's a beautiful call. Now this time Williams runs the defender off and Singler comes back and there's nobody left there. So there's nobody in that under coverage to challenge you. Bay City Central's playing straight man, so Midland's running crossing patterns against their straight man.
Well, Midland coaching staff just sees that out there. Coach Mettner.
Well, as a football coach, you're just salivating right now. You're just saying, okay, this is way too easy.
Williams in motion. Bad snap. Patton gets it, drives up ahead, and he's going to go in for the Chemic touchdown. Travis Patton with his third touchdown of the game. And just a tremendous drive by the Chemics right down the field.
He has burst. He has a burst that you don't see too often. Beautiful run right there. It was a screwed up play. He picks the ball. He makes a nice little move. And next thing you know, he's into your secondary and you're in trouble. And again, because they're playing man to man, everybody's way out into the flats trying to cover their man. There's nobody in the middle of the field.
Singer's extra point is up and good. And just like that, Midland takes a 21-14 lead.
Watch the burst on the replay here by Patton. So there's the flub. Now watch. You're going to get the ball right here, and here it comes.
Just a little
right
seam.
Right through there, and now he is gone. There's the burst. He knows where the end zone is. There are a lot of guys that don't know. They haven't got a clue as to where the end zone is. They do not know where the end zone is. He does. He knows.
He has scored 3 touchdowns tonight. Has 9 on the season now. And, it was a bad snap. Good poise by Johnson to keep the play going. Didn't even really miss a beat. And a nice hole on the left side there. Patton found the hole. He eluded the one tackler and then was off to the races. So 1:06 into this third quarter, And Midland takes their first lead of the game. Singer will be kicking off again for Midland High. Long hoop by the side.
Out
of bounds. Ouch. I always say that's the most severe penalty in football.
See, I like that play, but I like it once in a while.
Yeah, find that hole.
If I have a kicker like Singer, I'm going to try to get into the end zone because he does have the foot to put it there.
Yeah, he does.
And just say, okay, you know, I got a good kickoff team. We're going to pin you down as far as we can.
But Bay City will take the ball at the 35. Pros and College get it at the 40. Back to pass, intercepted.
Touchdown.
Didn't see him, and Scott Naples picks off the pass and rambles about 40 yards for paydirt. Touchdown, Chemics.
Now that is what undercoverage does for
you.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. That is undercoverage. And you have a guy at quarterback who is going to pass. So now you automatically say to yourself, if you're an outside linebacker at Naples, I'm dropping off.
All right. And Billette, you could look at it and say, why do you throw it right to him? But he just didn't see him. He was just sitting, dropped back, sitting there. It just did not see him on that pattern. Naples alertly grabs it, and he was off to the races. And the Singer's extra point is good again. And holy cow, two touchdowns in the first minute, 16 seconds.
The entire complexion of the game is going to change right here. There goes, sets back the pass. He's dropped off into the drop. See how he's in that drop zone? And now he's got a convoy. And you say, please don't fall down. That's as a coach that you're saying, don't fall down.
Actually, if he didn't, Goodwin might have picked that one off. He only saw a white jersey in that area, and there was a lot of blue. So Naples with the score for the Chemics. And man, has this game changed. If you go back to they scored with, 14 seconds to go in the second quarter. So that's three touchdowns in a minute and a half. Yeah, three touchdowns in a minute and a half. Wow. Singer will kick off again here.
Now, the question is, at this point, what happens to Bay City? Because they have been beat up as the season's been won. Will they fold? That's a question. As a coach on the sideline, you say, okay, if we put a good defensive stand and a good drop, they'll fold. And then you can do whatever you want. You've taken the heart out of him. Right there, he took him. That's a terrific kick.
Down to the two-yard line.
Let's see what he does with it.
He's got room to run. He's still on his feet. Cuts up the middle. Still going. Oh, man, what a return by Houston. From the two out to about the 35.
So maybe the squib kick isn't too bad.
Either way, it ended up on the 35.
35. I mean, I guess it just...
Oh, that was a nice return. He shows beautiful. Nice speed right
and
there.
And he ran away from the return.
Yeah. And so now it is Jones back at quarterback. Pitches it to Houston. Good coverage by the Chemic defense. He swarmed
ran
under
the
that
ball.
Play was just blown up from the beginning. A host of Chemic Smith in there. Sove in there. There was just nowhere to run for Houston. So big 4-yard loss.
I noticed this last week in the Mount Pleasant game. I love the way Midland swarms to the ball. They get a lot of people at the point of attack, and they get a lot of people on the ball carrier.
Now Billette back in at quarterback. Got to know where Jones is. He's looking for him. He's got him. Jones cuts up. Got one man to beat. Called from behind by Tyler Sove. He's a dangerous player, is Jones.
Now, let me say this.
They tried to get him in space,
and
he's dangerous.
If we take a look at the replay at some point on that play right there, you will see that the outside linebacker did not drop. Matter of fact, he stood at the line of scrimmage. If he drops, he intercepts it again.
But it's a first down for the Wolves at the 48-yard line. They just have two completely different offenses depending who's at quarterback.
Right.
This time it's the pitch to Houston. He cuts up and hauled down by Goodwin and Elmer. But he is able to pick up about four on the play. Good cut back by Houston. Second and six. All the momentum was in Bay City Central's favor for much of that first half. And then it turned dramatically in the last minute. And so now Bay City's trying to get some of that back. Jones keeps it. Oh, hauled from behind. Boy, it looked like he was going to take off.
That had
off.
The potential of being a good play.
And Terrence Thomas grabs him from behind, showing good strength there to haul him down for a minimal gain. Be third and four.
Now, I don't think, I'm looking at my notes here, I have yet to see a pass left out of Bay City. Every pass they've gone has been right.
Well, Jones, he threw some of those, that little out that he kept overthrowing
him. Yeah, Jones definitely has thrown every ball to the right. So who's the quarterback?
Oh, it's got to be Billette in this situation, Billette. Third and four.
So where is Jones? Jones is here. Billette will throw left to Jones.
He's looking for, tremendous rush. Oh, great play. Brady Harbron came storming in and blows the play up. Billette had no chance at all to get rid of the ball.
See, when you know it's coming, you can pin your ears back and just go.
Oh, and he did.
Right at the top of the screen. Oh. He just ran right by the blocker.
Shot that gap, and that was it. Harbor, huge play, because Bay City Central was showing a little life right there. Now they'll have to punt it away. Good long punt. Johnson will let it bounce. Great roll for Bay City Central. Go out of bounds at
inside
the 14.
The 10. Inside the 10.
Or excuse me, the 9. Nine. Yeah. Great punt. And so Midland High will take over. The first drive of this half. Very impressive. They just gained yards in chunks in that drive. And right now you just kind of sense that Coach Mettner and his staff feel like they have a lot of options.
Yeah, they found where they're at.
So here we go. Austin Rapanis in the center will snap it back to Johnson. Patton takes the handoff. Oh, man, that guy. He is a wall. Stone Manzik. When you run into him, you don't move any farther.
He's a player.
Because Patton, he had a good head of steam on him. He thought he could maybe drive for another yard or two, but he just stopped cold.
I'm always impressed at the timing of the snap, Johnson getting the ball and handing it off. I mean, it is
quick,
very quick.
Thomas Smith split out left, Singer to the right. Johnson back to pass, looks for Smith, he dives, it falls incomplete, threw that one behind him. Midland High offensive line, as we mentioned before, on the left side is 51 left guard Manny Hall, left tackle 56 Jacob Dostal, and right guard 66 Nick Aide, and right tackle number 72 Stephen Elmer.
Okay, where's 2-on-2, 4-on-4,
4-on-3.
This is a bunch on the outside. So we're looking at a screen.
Nope. He's looking. Johnson still looking. Extends the play. Throws it up for grabs. And Singer, incomplete. Defended well by Bay City Central, yeah. But all the receivers are on one side of the field. Johnson rolled to the left and did a good job extending it. But
you get a 4-on-4, it automatically tells everybody on the other side, zone it up.
Yeah.
Don't be messing around trying to cover. Go 4-4, 4-on-whatever it is, we're just going to go zone. Matter of fact, 3-on-whatever it is should be zone.
And so Midland will punt it away. Naples has the punting duties for the Chemics. Kicking from his own 10-yard line. Boots it, a nice high, long punt.
Excellent
fair catch
kick.
By Jones.
Excellent kick.
All the way back to the 46.
But great field position for Bay City.
Yeah, in Chemic territory. Now they're the ones with the two-touchdown deficit. Midland High was able to rally in the first half to come from behind, down by 2 touchdowns. Bates City Central is going to have to do the same here. 6 minutes remaining in the third.
See, Bates City Central has no identity because they have two quarterbacks. So they have an identity here with Jones, and that's run. And they have an identity with Belay, that's pass. So they have no team identity. You know, as a defensive coach, this guy's in the ballgame. We're just going to play the pass. And if this other guy passes, we're just going to intercept him.
Right, yep. Sove in on the tackle. Sove's playing a terrific ball game here for the Chemics in his linebacker position.
I love the charge of the down lineman. I mean, I've been watching them the whole game. They are down low and playing hard.
There's a pitch right for Houston. Cuts up. Oh, nice job by the Chemic defense. Michael Wright again. That's the second time he made a play like that on the pitch where he held his ground, held up Houston long enough for some of his teammates to come in, swarm, and finish him off. And so a loss on the play will make it 3rd and 11 for the Wolves. And, Billette is now in at quarterback in this pretty obvious passing situation. Jones, number 5, in the left slot. Got to keep an eye on him at all times. Billette's going to keep it. He fumbles the ball. We'll see who recovers it. He got hit from the side as he was running. It's going to be 4th down. Bay City Central recovers it, but they are going to have to kick it away. Good penetration by the Chemic defense.
Again, that down line is just coming so hard. See how they've changed the line of scrimmage? They've made a whole new line of scrimmage 4 yards deep in the backfield.
Harbrin in there as well as Thomas just blowing that play up. Billette really had no chance to survey the field. And so they'll punt it away again. Another nice high punt. Fair cut by Johnson at the 17. They have a nice punter. Thomas Jacobs is their punter and kicker. And he's got a nice leg. So after all these fireworks back and forth, settle down to a little defensive battle right now.
Kind of slowed down a little bit the way we saw the first part of the game. But it's just a matter of time before Midland gets them again. It's just going to matter of time.
I'm looking for the Roadrunner to break a big one here.
Well, I'll just go 2-on-2. Here, now they're going to go 3-on-3 out here. And see how they're all man-to-man up there? And that really should be a zone. They're going to play man. There it is. There's
bubble
the screen.
To Singer. And Mancek looked like he had some room to run, but Mancek from his linebacker position came over and hauled him down. But still a nice pickup on 1st down. Picks up about 7. And that little bubble screen where the receiver comes back for the ball and has his two other receivers in front of him to block. 3:44 remaining in the 3rd quarter. Trips right this time for the Chemics. Johnson's going to keep it. He's got a big hole. Bursts up the middle. Cuts left. Just tripped up. He fumbles the ball. Unless they're going to call him down. And Midland will retain possession either way. It'll be a first down. They did call it a fumble. Midland does recover. But a big play out to the 36. Johnson fakes the hand up to Patton. A good lead block. And good open field tackle by Houston, jarring the ball loose.
The official on this side got it right, that he was down on about the 37, 38-yard line.
Yeah, because about 2 or 3 yards.
Yeah.
Low snap. This time Smith on the ball screen, unable, a little too hot to handle. Was thrown high. Johnson was under pressure. And
see, that play is not there because if you take a look at Basie Central, they're all up. What is there? Just some sort of X pattern, you know, just two off, one out, and that's they can't cover it. They can't cover 2-on-2 and 3-on-3. They can cover a quick out or a quick screen.
Midland had done that successfully the first drive of this half, favoring the three wide out.
This is a run. Here.
Patton, a big hole, busts up, cuts left. What a cut by Patton. Is off to the races. Only Jones can catch him.
Can't catch
Patton.
Him.
Oh, hauled down finally by Jones, but not before a huge gain down to the 6.
You got to love what the Midland receivers did. Now, when we see the replay, the Midland receivers were almost all together on the sideline.
Almost to the sideline.
Three guys with
out of
them.
The play.
Yeah, out of the play, and then Patton just ran right where they had all lined up, and there was nobody else there.
Three secondary
guys.
So
once he broke the, then he cut back, and there's definitely nobody there. It was a great play by Jones. Here, see how they're all down here? Now they're all gone. And there's a great cut right there.
Travis Patton having a huge night. Good hustle by Jones to finally haul him down. But Midland knocking on the door at the 6. Rolls to the right, finds Williams, he drops the ball. Ugh.
Boy, you don't see that too often, huh?
Ouch.
That was a very well-designed play right there. Little motion in the flat, throw the guy in the flat, because the guy in motion is the guy who's got to cover him. I mean, there's a guy on the other side going man-to-man with him.
He'll keep that play. Coach Metner will keep that in his back pocket if he needs it later, because that was well designed, well executed, except for the.
Just come right back with it. Same action and throw the ball at the Singer in the flat, in the end zone.
Oh, that trips right. We're going to see a run here to Patton. No, Johnson's going to keep it and dives into the end zone. Touchdown, Chemics. They did that same thing where they turned it into an 8-on-8 game instead of 11-on-11.
Yeah, 8-on-8. 8-on-8 and run a crossback.
This time they fake the handoff, and Johnson, a very capable runner himself, makes one move, and then he can smell the end zone too.
When you have a player like Johnson who sees that out there, and you have coaches that understand a little bit of what's going on, it's like taking candy from a baby. You know, and I'm saying the Basie Central has run straight, pure man-to-man with no undercoverage for ever. Well, yes, forever when they had great athletes, forever. And they had great athletes inside.
Singer's extra point
again,
goes
here's
left.
Here's your big trips to the right, takes three guys out. You're 8-on-8. 8-on-8, and then the Patton takes them, and there he goes.
Just good blocking all the way around. Nick Aide.
Excellent play.
The guard out in front with the final block. And Johnson scores. We mentioned the extra point was wide left. But Midland now firmly in control with a 34-14 lead. The coverage of this Midland High football game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on the second Saturday in October. That's the 13th of October from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. The cost is just $45, which includes the annual access user fee. Call 837-3474 or come down to the MCTV studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. You can learn more about MCTV at www.midland-mi.org/MCTV, as you can see on your screen, or you can follow MCTV on Facebook. I'm sure you do that, Coach, don't you? You follow MCTV on Facebook?
Absolutely.
I thought so. Well, here we go. Singer with the kickoff. This is one of those pooch kicks. And that is, I believe that was Colin Wilbur on the return. Threw me off for a second. I thought it was Houston at first. I'm wondering what he was doing in
that
the front
up.
Row. Yeah, unless they were guessing pooch kick. But this time they'll get it at the 31-yard line. 2:11 remaining in the third quarter of this 2012 Midland High homecoming game.
Now, see, what Midland does with regard to that pooch punt, it forces you to eliminate two blockers. And what you have to have are offensive running backs or wide receivers up front as opposed to tight ends, that type of player.
This time Ballett throws the out pattern to Jones, and Jones will pick up the first down. Ballett throws a pretty nice ball. He's got a nice arm.
Now, notice, Dave, one of the keys to the game, I thought Midland had to score 30 points. Okay, they've now scored 34. And one of the things I'm looking at is you look down the road, you win this ball game, you're in the playoffs. All playoff teams are producing 30-plus points a game. In our region, all the way down to the semis, they're all scoring 30-plus points a game. Even a school like Canton that Midland defeated in the first game puts up 30. Even Mount Pleasant put up 30 last week. So you just got to say to yourself, we just got to put up 30 points a game. You got to score. Now, this has been a terrific second half for Midland.
Yeah, Ballett's pass knocked down by Thomas Smith. Another one of those cases where he just kind of held back, and Ballett was focusing in on one receiver. Didn't even really see Smith. It'll bring up a second and 10. I think we're going to see a pitch here. Nope, Ballett fires, throws it high. He's looking for Meath. Rolled to the left and tried to find Meath, but Meath has been the target on several occasions, and they throw it high to him, I think, every time today.
Well, he's tall, so I figure he should be able to get him.
I guess.
But tall
is not working out so well. Third and 10.
Well, quarterbacks used to always blame the hump here at the stadium, for throwing high, but we don't have a hump any longer.
No hump. So that's not the excuse. Third and 10. Keep an eye out for the man in the slot. That's Jones, his favorite target. It's a crossing pattern, and he's got Jones, and he's going to run out of bounds. He'll get the first. Down to the 42. Good reception. He's got some nice speed.
See, I'm really surprised that Midland doesn't send somebody out on top of Jones to kind of slow him down a little bit.
Give him a little bump.
Certainly, even a bump and drop is better than, I mean, you know he's out there. You know the quarterback only has eyes for him.
He's a tough cover, that's for sure.
Yeah, he's quick.
Yeah, you know it's coming
and
to him.
You know it's going to him, so you got to stop him and say, okay, stop. We'll stop the other guys one-on-one, but we got to have some help out here. He's all by himself at the top of the screen.
This time Houston gets the handoff. Good tackle by Harbrin. Calling Harbrin's name a lot tonight. Playing a tremendous game for the Chemics. 2-yard gain for Houston. Second and 8 from the 40. We're excited over at Northwood this fall, Coach. Timberwolves off to a 4-0 start.
4-0, isn't that fantastic?
Yep. Just started, only won two games last year.
And
a great start here, taking on Wayne State, who made the national finals last year. flag on the play. I think one of those receivers jumped early.
Okay, Dave, what do you think tomorrow? Wayne State, Northwood. Give it.
Well,
no, wait, give a number because here's, by the time people hear this, the game will have been
true.
Over. So you got to come right on.
Well, I'm not giving, no, I don't do that
got
for,
any
for our team like that. But
what do you think?
I think it's going to be a great game, and I feel good about it. I feel good about it. You know I'm not going
to
do that.
I know. I wanted to put you on the spot. I wanted to see what you were going to do. I mean,
I'm not.
I'm looking for Northwood to win.
All right.
I'm
going
to stand
like
right out
thinking.
There and say that, okay, Northwood's going to win. I'm
like
going to win by three touchdowns.
You're good at predictions, too.
Yeah.
He's looking for Meath again and just overthrown him. A lot of bumping going on there on the coverage, but Smith ran with him the whole way. He did a pump fake towards Jones and just overthrew Meath. I've said that a lot today. Great coverage, really, by Smith. He was with him every step of the way. Bring up a third and 13.
I think Midland has great pass coverage. I think they, you know, they play a man-to-man, but they're not afraid to play a man free. They're not afraid to play a man under. And as a result, their coverage is pretty good. What you have to try to do is catch them in the man that you can handle. See, basically, Central's not catching them. See, this is not... This is a trips to the field.
What? Under heavy pressure. Unloads. Got creamed when he let it go, and it's going to be almost picked off. Cody Meyer had a shot at it, but unable to hang on. But I am telling you, Ballett got drilled when he released the ball. I think it was Terrence Thomas. I'll give Ballett some credit because he knew he was going to take a shot when he let it fly, and he got blasted. He's shaking up a bit. He's coming out of the game. But it'll be fourth and 13. No, Ballett was just getting the play. He's yeah, they're going to have to call a timeout. They can't decide what they want to do here. So Coach Frazier calls timeout with 40 seconds remaining in the third period. Chemic faithful cheering on their team, excited about this big lead. Midland High really scored 34 unanswered points. If you think about it, it was 14-0.
Really?
And since very late in the first half, it has been all Chemics.
Well, in that situation, they've got, again, the throwing quarterback and the receiving quarterback in a two-man pattern. Even though they lined up three, but only to protect them on the quarterback on the trip side. So you knew that guy wasn't going out. So Midland covered number five without any trouble. And all, you know, should have had interception down here. So
really, this is the case. Number five, you really should just put two guys on. Because there's an 80% chance they're throwing it to him.
Absolutely. Just find five.
And if you throw it to somebody else, it's probably doing you a favor.
So now he's at the top of the screen all by himself.
And fourth and 12.
And there's a trips to the field over here, but Midland wants nothing of it. See, they've got a double coverage out here on number five.
Yeah, they're not biting.
They want nothing of that. And there's a throwback to him.
Throwing the post to him, and he's got him. Oh, man. Jones just runs the post despite double coverage, and Ballett throws a bullet on the money, and it's first down Bay City Central. Well, you just kind of knew that play was coming, too. Give Ballett credit. That ball was well thrown.
I give Ballett credit, and I give Jones credit for just
running the
freezing
pattern.
Running the pattern, and it's a beautiful job.
First and 10 for the Wolves at the Chemic 18. You wondered if they were just going to fold, but they're not. Fullback takes the handoff. That's Tarquin Rutledge. He's a junior. And that will be the last play of the third quarter. Tyler Sove on the stop. We have said Sove's name a lot tonight.
And see, Tarquin Rutledge was considered by their coach at the beginning of the season to be their running back. They thought Tarquett and Houston would really be a tandem. But Tarquett has not done anything with regards to being the kind of player that they thought he was going to be.
He's run for 175 yards, not too bad, has not scored yet. Billette, number eight, he's just a sophomore, coach. 5'10", 196. Good size kid, just a sophomore. We may be seeing some big things out of him down the road.
Only if Jones is a sophomore.
Jones is not a sophomore.
There you go, I mean.
Jones is a senior. List him at 5'10", 166. I would have guessed more than 166. Him, but to Bay City Central. We'll have a second and seven. Ball's on the 10-yard line. Billette at quarterback again. Fakes the handoff, play action pass, runs a post, and it's broken up. Goodwin read the play all the way. It was not to Jones this time. Just kind of a slant, and Goodman, he sniffed it out. Ball was a little too hot to handle. So it's a pass breakup, and it'll bring up a third and seven.
That was a good play call, though. That's the play you want there. You want that little slant.
Nate Bernthal was the intended receiver. Billette back to pass. Finds Jones. Good open field tackle by Cody Meyer.
Joshua Billette's pass is complete to Austin Jones.
And it is
very close.
Close to a first.
Very, very close.
They're going to take a peek at this one. And it is first down, Wolves. Good job by Meyer in the open field. Jones is a dangerous player.
Jones is amazing to me that, you know, we're sitting here knowing they're throwing to Jones.
Exactly.
And he's still getting open, and he's still catching the ball.
And he says, deal with it. Coach Mettner had mentioned during the week that Jones made him nervous. He was a big-time player that could go the distance at any time. This time, Jones is the quarterback. He's going to keep it hauled down from behind by Terrence Thomas.
That was a very good play.
It was.
That was open. The seam opened up, and Thomas closed it.
That's the second time that's happened where there was a hole there, and Thomas was able to, from behind, haul down the runner. That's a big play. Second and goal from the seven. Jones at quarterback. Goes to the fullback. Not much room to run by Tarquin Rutledge. Sove again with a stop.
There's not much there.
The play to the fullback just doesn't work. Midland's line is too strong for it. Like you said before, the straight dives at the middle is just not happening for Bay City Central. Third and goal from the four. Jones drives ahead. He's very close. Not quite in. I think he got down to the one.
Fourth and two.
Sove and Harbrin on the tackle. Yeah, that's at the. That ball is
well, I'm looking
inside the one. Fourth down. Fourth and goal.
Yeah.
At the 1 yard line. About the length of a football to go.
I'm going to bet quarterback sneak. Just on the basis of what?
Midland High is going to call timeout. They just did not like.
That's a good point.
The
right
formation.
That's an excellent timeout. Now, what this does is, see, you got to play in your mind as a coach. Okay, so the other team calls a timeout. Now that allows you doubt
just
in your mind.
To overthink
the
situation.
Yeah, you overthought the situation. You had a great play, but now they call timeout. So now you say, okay, maybe that play's not going to work, and you screw it up. I mean, the play here is quarterback sneak.
It'll be one that was more of a – they've had some success where he just kind of takes
a
one-step
little lean
quarterback sneak. And Bay City Central has to score right here if they want any hopes of coming back. I mean, they have a great opportunity right now. They're down by 20, down by three touchdowns. It's the Chemic student section and band having a great time here at the stadium. Friday night under the lights, high school football, you just can't beat it. Jones is the quarterback. It is quarterback sneak. He dives, trying to surge. He's got the touchdown. Both officials saw that. He only needed to get about a foot.
Here's the thing. He brushes the back of the side he's going to go on, which tells the running back, I'm going to block your back
and push you in the end zone.
So if they show the replay here, we'll see that happen.
We'll line up for the extra point first.
It's illegal, but.
Reggie Bush play against Notre Dame.
It's illegal.
Kick is up, and it sneaks through.
Got
makes
hit.
It 34 to 20. So Bay City Central did not get the memo that Midland High was going to run away with this one, and they're still fighting. Got to give them credit. Midland High had complete momentum and just an impressive drive.
Well, remember what I said, will Bay City fold?
They haven't.
And they haven't. They just came right back.
I mean, you got to give them credit.
I do. I'm impressed. 34-21, 9:25 to go. Look out for an onside.
Think this early?
I would. What have you got
to
lose?
You were that riverboat gambler.
Well, what have you got to lose? I mean, you got to, you know at this point exactly how many possessions you possibly have left. So that's not enough. There aren't enough possessions left. So you have to steal a possession.
Midland's
not going to give you a possession.
Well, Midland is figuring exactly that. And Midland thinks it's onside kick, and
so
the entire
Bay City Central,
team
so
is on the left side. That'd be somewhat of an indicator. So here we go. There's the pooch kick. I don't think it went 10 yards.
Nope. It did not, and it was touched there by Bay City.
It's one of those Bay City just has to wait a little longer, but you just can't help yourself. And they grabbed it at the 49, and it had to get to the 50 before they could legally touch it. Midland High will get the ball.
See, the only thing I would have made sure it was at least one guy back. Because if he kicks it beyond that,
then it's a race.
Then it's a race to the ball. At least put one guy back there.
They had got an outside kick earlier in the game accidentally.
All right, again, here's a three on two. You'll love this. Three on two.
This is a run. Just like you called
before. No question, it's a run.
It's Patton. Finds that hole again. Burst drives ahead. Just cannot quite elude Manzak, but a successful first down play for the Chemics. That play is just plain working. Picks up seven on the play.
See, I always think
it's six.
I always say good coaches are going to find you unless you're willing to disguise what you're doing. Well, basically, Central is not disguising anything. Good coaches will find you.
Williams takes the handoff, and Manzak hauls him down. He is a tough player. Boy, if he gets that edge, then we're about to see something exciting. But Manzak grabs him from behind and hauls down Williams for Looks like a yard loss. Manzik is everywhere for the Wolves. He's a junior, 6 foot 2'10". Third and five for the Chemics. This time fake handoff. Patton will take it, cuts out left. This time cuts up, drives ahead, first down for Travis Patton. What a tremendous effort.
That was all Travis Patton. He made three different moves in the process and then fell forward.
He is having a phenomenal evening. Three touchdowns already. And just that's just a big play
and
right
really,
there. That's a big play.
He's a step away from scoring there.
He keep moves the chains with that effort. Patton again. Not much room to run this time. Manzek along with
Manzek.
Brian Beadle on the stop. Or Bedell, excuse me.
Brian Bedell and Sean Manzek at the tackle.
Second and 11 for the Chemics. Time is on their side. Just over 7 minutes to go in the ball game. Full house backfield. Patton tripped up as he reached the line of scrimmage. Manzek calls him down again. Really no gain on the play. Manzek has a lot of tackles tonight, Coach.
Manzek is a Manzek. There's no question about it. I'd be offering him a scholarship.
Third and 11. Johnson under center, taking the snap from Rapanis. Hands it off to, no, he keeps the ball. Fake hand off Johnson, cuts up, cuts left. Still on his feet, gonna be just shy of the first down. Great effort by Johnson. Thought he had it, but it was brought down finally by Andre Houston.
Alec Johnson makes plays. He just makes plays.
Tremendous athlete.
He's very level all the way through. You know, you never see him do anything really exceptional and nothing really, he's just level. He makes all kinds of plays. And then just about the time you say, okay, you know, he doesn't do anything exceptional,
he does something
really special.
Fourth and two. Patton takes the handoff, drives ahead. He just will not be denied. He knows where the sticks are. He knows where the end zone is. He just gets that little bit extra when he needs that extra yard. He gets it. Midland High moves the chains and the clock continues to run. 5.5 minutes left in this ball game. Been a very entertaining evening here at Midland Community Stadium. It's a new set of receivers out there. I think we're going to see Patton, and Patton hit immediately. This time he's brought down by Bedell. No gain, maybe a yard. Midland High student section on their feet. Excited to see their team trying to put another win on the board. Johnson keeps it. He faked out a lot of people, including me. Faked the handoff to Patton and then went around the left end to pick up about 4 yards, bring up third and six.
Okay, you're now into your 4 minute offense. Now, 4 minute offense is the slowdown. Just slow the game down. You're going to run one play per minute. That's your goal, one play per minute, and finish the game out. You're not in any hurry here.
Johnson looking downfield, throws it, looks, and it is broken up. Tried to find Smith on the post pattern.
See that pass, you're down deep in their area. If you're going to throw a ball, you're going to throw something that's going to get you a first down, move the sticks. That pass probably was not the best choice by Johnson. And in this case right here, now you're going to try for a field goal. And again, your whole goal here was to run the clock out.
Singer will line up for a 39-yard field goal try. Smith, the holder. Kick is up. It's got the distance.
Good.
And it is good. Ryan Singer drills it with room to spare, 39 yards. That was a thing of beauty.
Beautiful kick.
Got good height. Sometimes a little longer field goal, you try to get too much and you don't get that initial height. Easy to block, but good elevation on the kick, and he was true. Ryan Singer hasn't caught a lot of balls today, but having a good game as a kicker.
The height on this kick is terrific. Nice job.
Yep.
That's a weapon.
There's
plenty of room. That is a big weapon for any team. You know, and assuming Midland now is going to go to the playoffs, 37-21, 3.5 to go. With six, they're going to get their sixth win and possibly go on and have an excellent chance at an undefeated season. That episode right there, kicking the 39-yard field goal, gives confidence not only to your team but to the kicker and sends a message to everybody else. Hey, we got a kicker.
Well, I was almost going to say, in a way, coaches might have just been kind of satisfied with being able to have that field goal attempt. Just for what you just said, because you hits that, and now you back your mind think, okay, we have this as an option. And with play is whistled, Dad's gonna be offside on Midland on the kickoff. So we got a little over anxious. And again, you have said before, look at Coach Matt Rapanis, defensive coach on the sideline. Midland has had year after year a quality kicker. And Brad Blasey has been the kicking coach for many years. He was a great kicker himself here as a Chemic. And
remember his
he just
dad,
does a great
Don,
job, of course.
It was the first kicking coach for Midland.
Okay.
And, well, he trained Brad.
He trained Brad, and his brother, Chris,
brother.
Was an excellent kicker as well. Kicked out at Air Force. Kick hauled in at the 8-yard line by Houston. Tripped up nicely. Colin Gagne on the stop. 3.5 minutes remaining here in the ball game. Midland High on the verge, as you said, barring a absolute miracle. Midland High on the verge of their sixth win of the season, guaranteeing them a playoff spot once again. Bullet goes deep. He's got Joe. Oh, he underthrew him that time. He had him for a split second. Really good one. Did a nice job at his safety spot coming over. Even if he had thrown it far enough, Goodwin may have had a shot at picking that one off.
They're going to pick it off now. I mean, they're in a position where they got 2-on-2 with a safety. So unless Bay City's going to be very patient and throw short, which they could do.
Well, Midland will take that at this point in time.
Yeah.
Pass again. Scott Jones will run out of bounds after picking up the first down. He catches the ball well, too. He's kind of softly brings it in with his hands, does Jones.
He's caught a lot of balls.
He has. This is the, I don't know, boy, it seems like this is the offense where you, they just have the most versatility with it. Although they really, even with Houston, they haven't run it all that successfully with Bullets in there. Bullet back to pass. Oh, he got drilled, forced the fumble. And
Midland has it.
That was Travis Patton. Have a game, Travis Patton. He came in from the left side. Bullet did not see him, and he just crushed him, forcing the fumble, and Thomas recovers. Look out, Patton taking on the blocker, shedding him. Patton did not see him on the blind side. He just engulfed him. Wow. Wow.
In Blaise's defense, he had no chance.
Oh, he had no chance.
No chance.
Well, Patton did a great job of shedding the blocker. And then he has that great burst of speed.
And then just got after it.
He is having one great game tonight. You'll remember this homecoming for a long time. There's Patton again, spinning ahead. Picking up another 4 or 5 yards. He's hobbled a little bit. He's limping right now. Coach sees that. He may want to. Get him out of there. You may not notice that he's it's gonna be tough getting him out of the game, however. Tough kid. Fullback Cam Short in front of Patton. Patton takes the handoff. Great job by Johnson. He got tripped up and was falling backwards, able to make a good handoff. But that play then got blown up.
He makes plays. Johnson makes plays. Even even that play right there, he saved the play.
He did. Yeah, that's a heady play. You get tripped and do that. It's you keep your wits about you and you still make the handoff. And this may surprise you, but Manzek stuffed that play. Third and 5 for the Chemics. Short in motion. There's a flag on the play. Oh, a delay of game for the Chemics. It'll bring us to a 3rd and 10. Minute 50 remaining in the ball game. Clock is running.
I've been most impressed with Midland avoiding the letdown. They've played hard tonight. And I've been impressed with Bay City Central because I didn't think they were even going to be in the ball game. And they've played hard tonight.
Yeah, Bay City Central is going to be able to beat some teams. No doubt about it. You better come to play when you take them on. The record's just 2-3. They're going to be 1-4 in the league after this game. But got to be impressed. They have some weapons. Patton takes the handoff. Nowhere to run. Tries that right side. And it's now 4th down. Bay City Central will call timeout. So, we will say we have timeout here. And And we look at ahead with three games to go here. You mentioned before, Midland High does have a shot at going undefeated this year. They will end up.
They play Saginaw next week.
Okay.
Then Bay City Western.
Who's 5-0 right now.
And then Dow.
So actually, you know, Saginaw High's struggling, although they've won two games. So it's not a gimme, that's for sure. And then the showdown against Dow High to end the season. Oh. It was almost like a pooch punt. It's almost like he saw the guy coming. He thought he could block it, so he just kicked it away from him.
Avoided the block.
So, then Bay City Western, as you mentioned, the second to last game. That'll be a great game. And then the city championship and game against Dow, which should be a great game as well.
With the Western game being over there.
Yeah.
Because I always felt that I was 10 points down. The moment
is that
I
right?
went, yeah. When, the moment I went to the cornfield, the score was 10-0.
Right, the wind is.
Well, the wind, the officials, the field. the hash marks, you know, a little
lines
shaky.
Are a little crooked.
Yeah, they're a little shaky.
Jones with another catch. Spins ahead. Good open field tackle by Smith. Picks up about 8 on the play. I think Jones may be in double figures in catches, you think? Seems like it.
The
anyway.
Game is a little longer to be in triple figures. He makes a lot of plays.
Well, this time it is almost picked off. Johnson had a shot at it. He broke it up. That's what you're talking about, where they just can kind of safeties can sit back and
know there's no run threat, so there's only going to be a pass threat.
And there's
so
really
just sit back there, play man under too deep.
And there's really one receiver running one sideline, another receiver running the other sideline. So you just, one safety's got this side, and the other safety takes that side. So 3rd and 2. Crossing a little shovel pass. It's going to be a 1st down for Bay City Central.
That was a street ball play. Yeah, you break the contain and, you know, run to the telephone pole.
Tyler Houston on the reception. Under a minute to go now. Ballett back to pass. Throws it. It's caught. Brought in by Carter Adams. It'll be another 1st down. Bay City Central, I mean, they're down 37-21, but still fighting. First body's in for the Chemics. Colton Colton on the defensive line. Tanner Diamond as well.
Interesting. Will Williams is on the defensive end out here.
That time it is picked off. And he's just going to go down. Intercepted by Brad Belson. Belson, the junior, with the interception. And then goes down on the return.
I love it when a second teamer makes a play, because that gives him heart. You know, he knows he can step in and play. That's beautiful.
Yep. Great job by Belson. Give him credit on this homecoming 2012. 30 seconds to go. Bay City Central does have one timeout should they elect to use it. Handoff. quite see who that was. Looks like it was number 20, Jared LaChance.
And that's going to be it.
And that will do it. Midland Chemics, after a slow start tonight, dramatic first half, and then they just really took charge in the second half. And so Midland High goes 6-0 on the year, and they are now 4-0 in the Saginaw Valley League. Bay City Central falls to 2-4 overall, 1-4 in the league. So, Coach, any final thoughts on the game tonight?
Well, the thing that impressed me the most, again, is Midland comes back from a big win last week against Mount Pleasant and did suffer a little bit early game letdown, but found enough to play well. I was impressed with Bay City Central. I thought they hit pretty hard tonight. They weren't as chippy as they usually are. I mean, you didn't see many penalties tonight, late hits. Or we saw one late hit, and it was on Midland. So, they're good things all the way around, and I'm impressed with Midland. I'm impressed with the way they play.
All right, we'll take a look at some of the highlights from the second half here, and there were plenty for the Chemics. This is Alec Johnson taking that in for the touchdown.
And that's a great run right there. Look at Patton, the motor. The motor is running at a high octane speed.
Boy, he had a great game here.
Terrific night. He's had two great games in a row, Dave. And here's a pass by Bay City Central that's intercepted by Naples and makes a great run into the end zone. Naples is an excellent running back. I mean, he could easily start for most teams at running back. And this is just an excellent run again by Patton. Look at that. And Jones just catches him. He'll hear about that from his friends.
Well, Jones can play, that's for sure.
Yeah. And again, there's a great run by Alec Johnson. And overall, pretty good ball game.
Yep. And this wraps up the scoring at 39-yard field goal by Ryan Singer.
And that's the interception.
Yep, in the game, Belson's interception. As they just hung back, and the excited Midland High fans, they cheer on their Chemics, happy to see a homecoming win. And we'll see what unfolds for the rest of the season, but a lot of exciting action in front of us. We'll be right back here at Community Stadium bringing the Dow High homecoming game next week.
With Heritage.
Against Saginaw Heritage. So we're looking forward to that ball game. Dow High going into tonight's action stands at 3-2 overall, 3-1 in the league. So they're having a good season as well. And so we're going to wrap things up here. Again, this is Dave Marsh bringing you the action tonight, along with Frank Aldemore, watching the game on MCTV. It's MPS TV 98. We're glad we could bring you the action. Again, Midland High with the big win over Bay City Central. Good night, everybody, and we'll see you next time.